Welcome, family and friends of Daryl and Donna. This is a very special time this afternoon. We're gathered here today in the presence of God and also you as being witnesses today as we join together and participate together in the renewal of their vows. 25 years ago, they joined their hands and their hearts together, and their lives were forever changed, weren't they? Today, they're saying not only would they do it again, but they are doing it again. And they are saying that before you to show that they desire to make their marriage not just work for another 25 years, but to thrive. They desire to see their marriage be a representation of what God wants it to be. Marriage was instituted by God and signifies to us the beautiful union that exists between Christ and His church. The Bible teaches us that marriage is God's plan for one man and one woman to be together as companions for life. Our Lord declared that man shall leave his mother and father and unite with his wife in the building of a home. The two shall become one. Let me just say it is a personal pleasure for me to be here today for this very special occasion. I knew God some 30 years ago. We won't go back how long. She was just a kid. In fact, we were all just kids, right, back then. But it's a joy. It was a joy to hear that Daryl and Donna wanted to renew their vows. Many people believe today in today's world that marriage is the final step of a romantic relationship where you meet someone and you fall in love and you decide to get married and to take that final step of marriage. But really, marriage is not a final step. Marriage is really just the beginning. And I would even say that the marriage, the union of two people, is a constant, amazing adventure. Hopefully that it will be fruitful and long for many, many years for you guys. You've shared joys, you've shared blessings, and you've probably had some challenges along the way. But you're still here. And not only are you here, but you are here today to recommit yourselves to one another. I want to ask you today, as you're thinking about this, not just to make a commitment to each other, but also to make a commitment to God, that we will make the most of our marriage so it will be an example to others. Our world needs to see married couples, don't they? Our world needs to see God's example of marriage. So today, as you reconfirm your commitment to work together to make your marriage grow and blossom in the years to come, my prayer is that this ceremony and the reunion of your vows will remind you that despite whatever stresses, whatever challenges you've had, that your love, that your trust, your respect, and understanding of one another will continue to increase and will double your joy as you move forward. Let's pray together. Father, I just thank you so much for the opportunity to be here this afternoon as we are amongst family and friends and we are celebrating 25 years of marriage. But we're also recommitting that this couple wants to do it the right way. They want to commit themselves to you, commit themselves to each other. So, Father, I thank you for this occasion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Will you please join hands and look at each other? All right. There you go. He's a lot taller than you, isn't he? So, Daryl, will you continue to have Donna as your wife? Continue to be committed to only her and to this marriage. Do you reaffirm your love for Donna, and will you commit to love, honor, cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful only to her as long as you both shall live? Donna, as you look up into those eyes, do you continue to take Daryl as your husband? Continue to be committed to him and him only in this marriage. Compared to all the things we see in our world, think about this example of love. If I were to speak in tongues of men and angels and have not love, I am nothing more than a noisy gong or clanging cymbal. If I have prophetic powers and understand all the mysteries and all knowledge and do not have love, it is nothing. If I give away all that I have and deliver up even my body to be burned and have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rather rejoices in what is right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things. Love endures all things. Love never ends. On your wedding day, you exchange rings as a symbol of the never-ending circle of your love. Rings remind us of the commitment that we have made. So as you look at your rings, and as you can join left hands, I mean, there you go. I'm gonna ask you to repeat after me. Here. Donna, I wear this ring.
Donna, I wear this ring.
You placed on my hand.
Placed on my hand.
As a symbol of my love.
Symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
Commitment to you.
Now, Donna, will you repeat after me? Daryl, I wear this ring. You placed on my hand. As a symbol of my love, and commitment to you. And now I ask each of you to remember to continue to cherish each other. Don't take each other for granted. After 25 years, you know each other very well. After 25 years, you know the good, the bad, you know all those differences. But look at this as also a new beginning. Look at this also as a new commitment, a stronger commitment to move forward. Many times we have to learn to forgive each other in a marriage. Many times we have to learn to look over our mistakes. But I want to challenge you as you move forward to move forward in a way that will show the world again how Jesus can change people. I want to ask you at this time to also renew the vows. You've renewed these vows today, making promises to each other, committing to each other, wearing the rings that you've had now for a while. Today is a day that symbolizes the renewal of your marriage upon the joining of your hands, the taking of the vows, and the wearing of your wedding rings. Remember this day just like you remember that day 25 years ago back in April. Let's pray again. Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for this couple. Father, I pray that this couple would be an example to all of us, that each and every day we would recommit ourselves to you and to each other. Father, we pray that they would be an example to other young people who would look and see maybe marriage is not as important for some people, but Father, it is your plan and it's a perfect plan. So we ask that you would use them to be a testimony to many others. Father, I pray for understanding, for respect, for forgiveness, but for a love that would continue to grow now and forever with Daryl and Donna. Father, we pray and we praise you for what you've done in their life, and we thank you for what you're going to continue to do in the future. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. It is with pleasure that I conclude this ceremony by the renewal of the vows, and I will ask Daryl, you can kiss your bride. Very good. All right, I'm going to present to you now, husband and wife again, and I'm going to ask you to stand and give them a standing ovation. Thank you, sir. Daryl and Donna would like to invite you to a reception. It's going to be downstairs, and so we'd love to have everybody to come on down and do that. Will you pray with me? Father,